delegates special from the Republic of Seychelles and representing the youth generation, three students, little children, Hudson, little one, Viraj, to light up the oil lamp. Traditional oil lamp right now, Honorable Prime Minister, the Democratic Socialist Republic of Sri Lanka. Dr. Sukumar here, Chairperson of Global Energy. Let's go.
Oh, Ranil Wickremesinghe, the Democratic Social Republic of Sri Lanka, to be on stage, and most venerable Dr. Interfaith Dhammalankara Mahanayaka Thero, venerable Barnagala Upatissa Nayaka Thero, H.S. Isa Swami, Reverend W.P. Ebenezer Joseph, Swamiji Swarna Rupananda, and I call upon Dr. Sukumar Nair, Chairperson, Global Energy Parliament, and Sir James Mansham, Founder President of the Republic of Seychelles, and Architect Mr. Kartisha. Please welcome, sir, on stage. Energy Parliament, the habitat of harmony, will look at one of the most pressing questions facing by humanity. And for the last 7 years, the contributions they have made in terms of achieving the most pragmatic solutions is commendable. So once again, we are here to find more and more innovative solutions through this session, the 7th edition of Global Energy Parliament. Up next, I call upon to deliver the welcome speech at this occasion, Reverend Father W.P. Ebenezer Joseph, Secretary GEP 2016 Committee, Secretary General Interfaith Coalition for Peace, Secretary General National Christian Council of Sri Lanka, to address the gathering.
Most Venerable Dr. Itapana Dhammalankara Mahanayaka Thero, Venerable Barnagala Upatissa Nayaka Thero, Venerable Isha Swami, members of the Mahasangha, and members of all religious clergy, the Prime Minister of the Democratic Socialist Republic of Sri Lanka, Honorable Ranil Wickremesinghe, Sir James Mansham, the Founder President of the Republic of Seychelles, members of the Parliament, ministers, governors, and all members of the Global Energy Parliament 2016, and friends from both abroad and Sri Lanka. It is my pleasure and privilege to welcome every one of you to this inaugural ceremony of the Global Energy Parliament 2016. Your gracious presence is sincerely acknowledged on behalf of the Interfaith Coalition for Peace, the Mahabodhi Society of Sri Lanka, and the National Christian Council of Sri Lanka, who are hosting this event this year in our beloved country. Habitat harmony is a relevant theme for reflection, especially for all those who are living in Sri Lanka, who as a nation is pursuing the paths of justice, peace, and reconciliation among all religious, ethnic, and linguistic communities, and also striving to cohabit with the nature and our environment of trees, animals, plants, water, and air. We are sorry that His Excellency is unable to be present with us today due to urgent meetings that he had to attend. But we proudly recognize His Excellency's leadership to this pursuit of every peace-loving citizen in this country, blending harmoniously by upholding religious values and spiritual foundations that has sustained this island over the centuries. Honorable Prime Minister, your leadership in making science and modern technology the tool for all the welfare of all citizens in an atmosphere of four major religious spiritualities is of equal importance. This beautiful blend leads us to an harmonious habitation of all living beings in this island. Your presence is a symbolic value to the theme that will be deliberated throughout this day in this August Assembly. The presence of the committed and sincere religious leaders, the Manaika Theros, the Swamijis, along with the specialists and in the secular professions, will make the deliberations truly a fruitful one. Hence, it is my privilege to welcome every one of you this morning with open arms and heart, and pray that the deliberations of this day will benefit all humankind, especially the poor, the downtrodden people in this world. And we believe that this will also shed new light to the pursuit of peace and justice in this our beloved island. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Reverend Father W.P. Ebenezer Joseph, for the welcome speech. And up next, we are here to welcome to do a very important introductory talk, speech. Really, he's the most ideal personality, in fact, to divulge all about the most important term, Global Energy Parliament. I welcome Dr. A. Sukumaran Nair, Chairperson, Global Energy Parliament, to address the session.
Honorable Ranil Wickremesinghe, esteemed Prime Minister of Sri Lanka, His Holiness Jagatguru Swami Isa, founder of the Isa Prajnana Trust and President of the Global Energy Parliament, Sir James Manjam, founder president of Seychelles, esteemed spiritual heads on the dais, other distinguished delegates to the Global Energy Parliament, ladies and gentlemen, I deem it a great privilege and a great honor to be asked to address the world meet of internationally minded people from different parts of the world, assembled here in response to the call of one of the foremost spiritual leaders of our times, His Holiness Jagatguru Swami Isa. Global Energy Parliament is Swamiji's answer to many of the crucial problems faced by humanity during the second decade of the 21st century. The present day